How long do you think it took to fill this thing? Decades?
Hey.
Got my attention. Little something to liven up the day?
Oh, nothing.
Yeah, sure.
Hey. Wait there.
Requests.
What if I redirect the flow through here?
Excuse me.
That's a ticket. You do the honors. Hit that switch on the end of the pump.
Hey.
Gotcha.
Come on.
I'll keep an eye out. How long do you think it took to fill this thing? Decades?
Maybe if I close off this intake, I can get enough pressure.
Hey there.
Meyer Lopes. I guess I shouldn't be surprised that stirred him up. Anyway, I still got some tinkering to do on this thing. Shouldn't be too hard now, though. Thanks for pitching in. There's a little something before you clear out.
Hey.
You mind? I'm busy here.
Thank you.
You just say the word if you want to take a little chem break. Room for one skinless freak around here.
Show your face. Come on. I dare you.
Won't recognize you. I guess you could call that trying. Ripe for the taking.
Heads up.
Hmm?
Hancock.
So, seems you know how to hold your own. I'd had my doubts when we first hit the road.
Thanks. You're not so bad yourself.
I never get many complaints. It's just real rare these days. Find someone who's not willing to take things the way they're handed to them. Too many good folks not willing to get their hands dirty. And too many assholes taking advantage of it. Look at what happened to Diamond City. Before McDonough took over, it was a half-decent place to live. A little stricter than I usually go for, but not terrible. I thought he and I had a pretty happy childhood. But then he decides he's gonna try and get elected with his anti-ghoul crusade. Mankind for McDonough. Before you know it, you got families with kids lining up to drag folks they call neighbor out of their homes and throw them to the ruins.
You and McDonough knew each other as kids?
Oh yeah. Guy's my brother. Grew up together in a little shack on the waterfront. Guy was the standard big brother. Entitled. Punchy. Liked to shove rotten potatoes down my shirt and slap my back. But I never thought he'd be capable of something like what they did to those ghouls.
Why did McDonough campaign against the ghouls?
Because he thought he could win. There'd always been a pretty clear divide between the folks living in the stands and those down on the field. I'm not convinced they didn't do it just to improve their view. I remember storming into his office above the stands after the inauguration speech. He was just standing there, staring out the window, watching as the city turned on the ghouls. He didn't even look at me. Just said, "I did it, John. It's finally mine." Should have killed him right there, but I don't think it would have changed anything. Instead, I pleaded with him, begged him to call it off. He said he couldn't. He had nothing against the ghouls. He was just carrying out the will of the people. And he couldn't betray the voters. And then he smiled. That hideous fucking mile-long smile. He never smiled like that when we were kids. I didn't even recognize him.
What do you mean you didn't recognize him?
I don't know. Just didn't seem like the guy I grew up with. When I'd first heard the rumors, he'd been swapped for a synth. Thinking back on that night, I thought it made a lot of sense. But now, I don't know. I don't think I buy it. I've seen him since then, and there's no way they copied him that perfectly. Even got his tight-ass walk. But at the time, I just needed to get the hell away from him. Him and that whole damn city.
Of all the things I've seen since leaving the vault, this seems almost merciful.
Sure. No one got beheaded at first. I still wasn't a ghoul at this point, so I didn't have to leave, but I couldn't bring myself to stay in that cesspool after that. I'd been sneaking off the Good Neighbor for years to get decent chems, so I knew the safe routes. I managed to track down a couple of the families, lead them there, but most couldn't get used to the Good Neighbor lifestyle. I brought them food for a couple of weeks, but after a while, they just disappeared. Folks in Diamond City signed their death warrants. And all the good people were willing to just sit by and watch. I felt like I was the only one who saw how screwed up things truly were. Who couldn't just pretend things were fine. Still feel that way. Or I did. Until I met you. I know I run my mouth, but having someone who sees the world for what it is and is willing to do something about it, it's meant a lot to me. I feel damn lucky to have you as a friend.
Doesn't seem like there's a lot of competition for the post.
You ain't lying. It's awful lonely for us folks at the top. Well, thanks for hearing me out. You probably weren't looking for a history lesson, were ya? You wanna hit the road? Take whatever you can. I'll keep watch. Looks like they dug in deep here. trinkets like these gotta be worth something, right? Something ain't right about this place. Wouldn't give for a flashlight about now.
Show your face! Come on! I dare you! No need to hide. It'll all be over soon.
Setup. I guess this area ain't regularly part of the tour. Is that actually worth something? doubt this place has ever seen the delicate touch of a Mr. Handy. No one's been through here in a while.
Got it.
You hear? I'd do the same if I was in as much trouble as you. Generators in here.
I guess this area ain't regularly part of the tour.
That's it.
Learning went into putting together a place like this.
Locked.
Well, someone sure wanted to keep out trespassers. No one's been through here in a while.
Thank you. I've got that locket back for you.
You serious? That's great news. Connie's gonna be speechless. I'm sure she'll go lean on her prices after what you've done. And feel free to use our workshop. Least we can do.
I just want to trade a few things.
Sure. approach and identify.
Take whatever you can. I'll keep watch. I got something.
You scared now?
Use some jet after that.
Hey there.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
Didn't you ask the Minutemen for help?
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors. But honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock in the Minutemen these days. After Quincy. Bad business, that.
Is there something you need my help with?
Oh, yeah. I'm damn glad you're here. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks. Stealing food and supplies, threatening to kill us all if we don't pony up. We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against a gang like that.
Will you be willing to join the Minutemen once I've dealt with those raiders?
We'll certainly give it a good long think. People have gotten used to not being able to count on you folks. That's not going to change overnight.
Brotherhood.
Jackpot.
Perfect. Thank you.
Who?
Now, what do you think?
Hearing shit.
Huh?
You gotta be joking.
You better hide. Money by the best.